Don't buy me flowers, don't buy me sweets. Don't give me useless little things that'll make me complete.
I grew up in Northwest Ohio. I have two brothers, and one's a twin brother, actually. We grew up in the country and lived on a farm, and chickens, cows, pigs, horses, all those things, and it was really nice to be able to grow up in a rural community.
But then came a year in Crystal's childhood that changed everything.
I was six when I found out I had diabetes, but it didn't make sense to me then. I think it's too big for a small child to really fully grasp. My first interest in music was about the same time I was diagnosed. I had about 3 years of piano lessons, and I faked my way through it, and then finally realized that a guitar is much easier to carry than a piano.
I don't want your money, honey, Lord, it's kind of funny, I just need your time, and to know that your sweet love is mine all mine.
By the time Crystal was 10, her mom had already set her up with her first gig.
As I remember one place, it was Judy's Tavern, and we would go there every Friday. I learned 10 songs and slowly started learning more and more, and realized that I could make money doing it. I could do this for a living. It was amazing to me.
Meanwhile, Crystal also had to make sense of her diabetes.
Oftentimes, as a diabetic, you are treated differently. And in high school, remember, I was once made fun of for being diabetic. And using the word, like, oh, you stupid diabetic. And it just blew my mind. I was like, really? Really? You know, this is something that I can't control as far as having it. There has been shame in having diabetes in the past, but not anymore.
By the time she was 17, playing little country bars just wasn't enough.
At the time, I had never visited Chicago. I just knew that it was the biggest, closest city, and there had to be more opportunity there. So I went down there, and I became a street musician.
Crystal played Chicago for the next 5 years, until the next chapter of her life began.
In 2008, I found out that I was pregnant, and it changed my world.
And it also led Crystal to consider something she might never have considered before, American Idol.
When I had my son, I realized I've been doing this a while, and dagnabbit, I've paid my dues. And it's do or die now, it's now or never. And for my son, I tried out, and thankfully I did. My son saved my life.
Crystal passed the grueling American Idol auditions and began advancing through the field. But she was carrying a secret.
I had hid the fact that I was diabetic from the producers because I didn't want any extra attention. I was somewhat ashamed of it. I just didn't want anyone's sympathy, and I thought that I could handle it on my own.
But by lowering her guard on control, Crystal nearly lost everything.
The schedules are so crazy on American Idol that a whole day had gone by, and I realized that I hadn't checked my sugar. And my priorities were just all mixed up, and my health went to the wayside, and I became ill.
She developed diabetic ketoacidosis, or DKA, a life-threatening condition caused by extremely high blood sugars.
And I was hospitalized, and I remember the executive producer, Ken Warwick, came into my room, and I thought, oh, that's nice. He's come to visit me. And he sat down and had everyone else leave the room, and then said to me, well, darling, you're off the show. I was so angry, and I lashed out like I was angry at him, but really I think I was angry at myself. How did I let this happen? How could I be so careless and so irresponsible to let diabetes control my life? And I made a decision that day that it was never going to happen again.
Crystal pushed back hard to keep her spot on the show, and the producers finally relented. But the question remained, did Crystal have the strength to continue the very next night?
The music started, and I took my spot.
Though I'm going, oh, I'll be coming.
And I just felt this overwhelming sense of gratitude that I was standing there and able to stay in the competition, and I just let it out of me. And I still probably wasn't as well as I should have been, but that was a turning point in my life forever.
I have to tell you something, Crystal. I completely misunderestimated you from last week. Thank because you. For you to come back this week with that song, that performance, the vocal was incredible. And I promise you, this was like the moment we realized that we've got a serious artist.
Amen. Thank you. Amen.
Crystal made it to the finale, ultimately finishing as the 9th season runner-up.
It's given me a career. I got a record deal out of it. My son has room to run and a roof over his head. But I think really the best thing for me personally to come out of American Idol has been my shift in how I look at diabetes. Before I looked at it really as a burden or as this big secret, something that made me different in not maybe a positive way. And I've definitely changed my mind about that.
Far from feeling shame, Crystal is now committed to sharing her hard-won diabetes knowledge. She even got a chance to team up with the legendary B.B. King to spread the word.
Well, hello. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
May I shake your hand?
Of course.
Well, thank you.
May I hug you?
Come later.
All right.
Getting to work with B.B. was amazing. And the history that he has and the stories he could tell, I could sit and listen for a very long time.
Crystal also likes talking to her audiences.
My favorite part really is when a fan will come up with an insulin pump or something and just be like, hey, I got the beatus too. You know, I want to live life on my terms, and in order to do so, that means that I need to check my blood sugar and eat healthy and exercise and control my diabetes, or else it'll control me, and I don't want to let that happen.
Ooh, honey, I love you. You're my own love.